was lumped up together, you know.
The 14-member Joint Parliamentary Select Committee has 28 days to receive and review complaints against the IEBC commissioners and secretariat and recommend electoral reforms that would ensure a free, fair and transparent general election next year. But operations of the committee, established to end weeks of violent mass protest staged by code luminaries and supporters to push IEBC commissioners out of office over perceived bias, could be hampered by a looming showdown with the Justice and Legal Affairs Committee.
I know there's been concerns out there, especially because of the process being done by the Legal Affairs Committee. We are working with my co-chair as a team to make sure that this process is not interrupted and that this process delivers.
IEBC commissioners, while appearing before the Legal Affairs Committee, raised issues on the mandate of the Select Committee and claimed their rights to a fair trial would be violated.
We would like to get some guidance from the committee as to whether this committee or that committee are not going to duplicate the work, and secondly, whether the commissioners will not be subjected to double jeopardy.
Anyone else who is doing something else outside that, you know, of course, what your rights are in under the Constitution, and you know where you can go and protect them.
The friction between the two committees was triggered by a contest on the application of Article 251 of the Constitution that outlines the grounds and procedure of sending the commissioners home.
You should not allow yourself to be dragged into another committee over the same mandate that this committee is carrying out. In my mind, that other select committee was just supposed to get the demonstrators out of the street.
The Legal Affairs Committee is keen on upstaging the Select Committee since it was already handling a petition filed by Nyukuri Barasa seeking the removal of IEBC commissioners on ground of incompetence and lack of integrity. The Select Committee, however, hopes to use its links with Parliament's top leadership to compel the Legal Affairs Committee to shelve its IEBC probe.
So we'll be talking to all the authorities concerned to make sure that we take this process yet.
The Select Committee will on Friday convene a day-long retreat to settle on the operational procedures and choice of joint secretaries before inviting views on IEBC from stakeholders and members of the public.
The apparent confusion and duplication of functions between the two committees of Parliament has triggered sibling rivalry that could derail the pursuit of key reforms on the electoral body before Kenyans return to the ballot next year. The Legal Affairs Committee has on Tuesday summoned the IEBC commissioners to appear before it to respond specifically to the allegations of incompetence that were raised by the Auditor General in his 2014 report. Francis Gashuri, Citizen TV, Nairobi.